Hi there, my name is Shiraz Balolia and I'm the captain of the United States F-Class Open Rifle Team for the 2013 World Championship Cycle. Today we're going to talk about team shooting and how a coach and a shooter work together. We're going to shoot at 800 yards later on, but before that we'll go over the target and the importance of keeping your shots as a shooter in a very tight vertical. This is known as the waterline of a target. Your job as a shooter is to make sure that every shot is as tight vertically as possible to the waterline. And I'll give you a few examples of why that's important. For example, you have a good wind call and you take your shot and it ends up here. Had that been a good waterline shot, you would have clipped the 10 ring and had a nice 10 points instead of 9 points. Same thing with an 8 to a 9 and so on. Your rings are the widest right in dead center. So the closer you are to the center, the more points you're going to have. This is an NRA long range target. This target is used for 800, 900, and 1,000 yard shooting. It's got an F-class center on it. Basically, it's a Palma iron sight target and the F-class center, which has much tighter rings. The ring, the X-ring on this target is 5 inches in diameter. The 10 ring is 10 inches. The 9 ring is 20 inches and so on. We're going to talk about scoring on this target. Every time a shot is taken, there's a person in the pits that pulls down the target and marks the shot as well as scores where your shot was. And I'll give you an example. If it's an X, there's a big scoring disc that's put up here. That's an X, a 10's down here, 9, 8, 7, and a 6. Now you're wondering, how does the shooter know or the scorekeeper know whether it's an X or a 6? Well, every time a shot is taken, there's a shot spotter that gets put in the bullet hole. So there's an X. There would be a 10, 9, and that gets moved down here. The scoring disc would get moved down here for a 9. If it's a 6, what happens is this thing gets turned over. Ignore these numbers because that's for a different target, but this is actually the 6 ring. That's a 7, that's an 8. So this gets turned over. So the first thing that's going to happen is the scorekeeper is going to look for a shot in here because he thinks it's an X. He doesn't see a shot spotter there, so he's going to look around the target to see where the shot spotter is. That's when he'll see this and he'll call it a 6 if he's not asleep. I'd like to introduce you to our coach today, who is Gary Rasmussen. Gary is a coach on the United States Palma team, and hi Gary, how are you? He's been a shooter on many U.S. teams, he's been a coach on many U.S. teams, he is a well-accomplished coach. In fact, he actually coached the United States FTR team into a gold medal at the last World Championship. So Gary knows what he's doing. Gary, you've given a lot of wind reading classes. Perhaps you can fill us in on the relationship between a coach and a shooter and what you look for.
Sure. Yeah, the coach's job is to determine what the wind is doing downrange so that he can tell the shooter where to aim the rifle. The bullet is going to drift depending on how much wind there is and what the angle of the wind is. So I'm going to maybe put a correction on his rifle sight so the bullet will actually go into the wind and then curve back into the center of the target if everything is perfect. In F-class with a rifle scope, you're always aiming off. We might put a certain windage on and then we would aim left one, right one, or left two, right two, or maybe even 2.5. And it's all depending on what the wind is doing. And when the shooter takes the shot, hopefully the most accurate shot the person can take. As Shiraz mentioned about the water line here, if we could get that bullet to just arc right back in and right into the X-ring.
Okay, Gary, why don't we go shoot?
Okay.
All right.
Okay, Shiraz, you're ready to go. What caliber are we shooting today?
I'm ready. We're shooting a 284 Shahan, which is 7mm.
Okay, and what weight? In the bunker, you are clear to shoot.
Roger that. And what weight bullet?
It's 180 grain Berger hybrid.
Okay. Do you know what the velocity is?
It's about 2930.
2930, okay. Yeah. Okay, we're all set up, getting ready for our sighters here. I've been watching the mirage. It's coming from the right a little bit. So we're gonna shoot slightly to the right on your sighters. Okay, Shiraz, your first sighter here, I'd like to have a right one, right one. Very nice shot, Shiraz, just slightly low. Go ahead and take a click.
One click up.
Okay. Okay, Shiraz, this time I think we're gonna do a center shot. Looks like the wind came down just a little bit. Center shot, Shiraz. We're still coming from the right, but it just kind of comes up and down, up and down. Okay. First shot for record coming up, Shiraz. This is a right one. Shiraz, right one. Okay, we just clipped it. One more click up. Let's go just outside right one, like one and a half, right one and a half. It's like we're going back to the center a little bit on this next shot. Right one, Shiraz, right one. Do we need another click up, do you think?
Let's see what this comes up.
Okay.
Yeah, yep. Probably.
Yeah, one click up.
One click up.
Okay. We're gonna go back to that right one, Shiraz, right one. We might be going into the center on the next shot. It looks like the flags are dropping just a little bit. Yep.
You want me to come center. Up a click?
Center shot.
You want me to come up one? A click?
What was that?
You want me to come up?
Yes. One click.
One click up.
Okay, Shiraz, this is going to be a center shot. Very nice. Okay, Shiraz, a center shot. We might want a favor just slightly left, even though we still have right mirage. No, we're okay. Okay, Shiraz, center shot. Shiraz, we're going to just aim slightly to the, oh, that last two were high.
Yeah.
Come down one click.
Coming down one.
One. We're going to favor slightly right, just slightly right of center.
Okay.
Not a full one, but just slightly right.
It's about a half.
Okay. Very nice. Do that again. The wind's dropping down just a little bit. So let's go back to center. Center shot.
All out.
And we're all out. Very nice. We got a perfect score, I think.
Yep. Woo!
Right on the water line.
Good job, Gary.
Okay, that is our string of fire in the pits. We have finished that.